Hi, welcome to Chemicpedia chemistry classes for 11th standard. This session I'm going to discuss about the Hund's rule, which is in the atomic structure lesson unit number 2. Hund's rule, which is also called as principle of minimum pairing or principle of maximum multiplicity. In the exam sometimes they may ask the same topic as either principle of minimum pairing, the condition for minimum pairing of electron, or principle of maximum multiplicity. Okay, so first I say the principle: no pairing of electrons in the degenerate orbitals occur until all the orbitals have one electron each. See, while filling electron in degenerate orbital, first we have to fill one electron each in all the orbitals, then only you can start pairing. Okay, that is the exact meaning of this Hund's rule. No pairing of electron take place in the degenerate orbitals until all the orbitals contain one electron each. Otherwise, this can be simply stated as no pairing of electron until each orbital is singly occupied. No pairing of electrons in the degenerate orbital until each orbital is singly occupied or half filled. You know, degenerate orbital is nothing but orbitals such as px, py, pz, which are having equal energy, like orbitals like dxy, dyz, dzx, dx square minus y square and dz square. While filling electrons in such degenerate orbital, first each orbital should get one electron, then only you can start pairing. For example, when you take p orbital, the fourth electron only getting paired with the first electron. Px, py, pz, px one electron, second electron goes to py, third electron goes to pz orbital, only the fourth electron is getting paired with the first px orbital. Likewise, when you consider d orbital, so there are five orientations in d orbital, isn't it? So that only the sixth electron can get paired with the first electron. Okay, so that's the meaning of Hund's rule. Now we are going to see the explanation for Hund's rule by writing electronic configuration for first 10 elements. Okay, I have written the element symbol with the atomic number. So first element hydrogen with atomic number 1, it has one electron, so then that one electron will be added in 1s orbital. Then the second one, helium with atomic number 2, the two electrons are added in the same 1s orbital. Because you know s orbital can have maximum 2 electron, p orbital with 6, d orbital with 10, f orbital with 14. So these are the maximum number of electrons which can be located in the orbitals. S with 2, p with 6, d with 10, f with 14. Now helium, the second electron also getting added in the same 1s orbital. Now the third one, lithium with atomic number 3. So first and second electrons are getting added in 1s orbital. Now the third electron, so 1s is completely filled now. The third electron goes to 2s orbital. So next one, beryllium with atomic number 4. First electron, second electron completely filled. Third electron to 2s orbital. Fourth also in the same. Then boron. Now you can see the 2s also completely filled. But in the next element, boron, the fifth electron may go to the next orbital of atomic number 5 for boron. So the electrons are filled this way, 1, 2, 3, 4. The fifth electron will go to 2px orbital. The fifth electron of boron goes to 2px orbital. Okay, right. So next one, carbon, atomic number 6. There are 6 electrons. Let me fill the 6 electrons this way, 1, 2, 2 in 1s orbital, 3, 4. 2 in 2s orbital, 2 more electrons are there, isn't it? 5, 6. This way you cannot fill. That's what the Hund's rule says, okay? The 5th electron and 6th electron both cannot be added in 2px orbital. So now what will happen is, when the 5th electron is getting added in 2px orbital, the 6th electron will go to 2py orbital. That's what the statement, no pairing until each orbital is singly occupied. So you cannot start pairing without having electrons in the 2py and 2pz orbital. That's why after adding 5th electron in 2px orbital, 6th one will go to 2py. If you have a 7th electron, probably that will go to 2pz orbital. So let's say on hydrogen, atomic number 7, 7 electrons, 1, 2, 2 in 1s orbital, 3, 4, 2 in 2s, so 3 more electrons are there, isn't it? 5th, 6th, 7th electron. Now 5th electron in 2px, 6 in 2py, seventh electron is getting added in 2pz orbital. Okay, so now you can see that in case of nitrogen, all the 3p orbitals are getting one electron, isn't it? So that from the next element onwards, the electron panning can take place according to the Hund's rule, because each orbital is singly occupied in case of nitrogen, so that we can start pairing very well from the next element. Okay, right. So oxygen with atomic number 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, half filled orbital. So 8th electron is getting paired with the first electron, that is px electron. Okay, right. Then fluorine atomic number 9 electrons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8th electron is paired with px electron, 9th electron is getting paired with py electron. Okay, so this is how to fill the electron in various atomic orbitals according to Hund's rule. The last one, neon with atomic number 10, 10 electrons are added this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, now the 8th electron here, 9th one here, 10th one here. Okay, right. So this is a simple explanation for Hund's rule. Thank you.